Now, as we already found out in our discussion today, it's hard to talk about Titanfall without mentioning Call of Duty, right?
Yep.
True.
Another one of our viewers, Mark Clifford.
The dog?
Yes, Mark Clifford the dog writes in asking,
woof, woof,
my kid
woof,
loves
woof,
the dog. Because he's the big red dog.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm sitting on a house.
With the release of Titanfall this week, do you think it will be the death of Call of Duty? I think splitting the game between three studios was a good move and will hopefully provide some freshness to the franchise as it's gotten stale lately, but will it be enough? He's talking about the developers that are working on Call of Duty games.
I have some verbal diarrhea I can spout about
this. Here we go.
Oh. If you guys want.
Vomit on us.
Uh-oh. So,
that's not what diarrhea is.
No.
It's the opposite.
Let's just vomit the other way, but anyway.
Got it.
So short term, no, but I think what's going to happen, because you know, if only for no other reason, it's not on PlayStation platforms, and whereas Call of Duty's on everything.
Yeah.
But I do think that we've gotten to the point where Call of Duty, some fatigue has set in. You know, Ghosts, I don't think it's sold as well as other Call of Duties have. And I think Titanfall, the mechanics are so much fun. It really is designed for people who like Call of Duty.
The mechanics are so much fun. Aransky's B-roll is the training modules. I'm like, here's how you don't put it off, you coward.
But anyway. Once again, I source most of the B-roll, so it's not Aransky's fault.
Sorry, Mike. Aransky. Yeah.
But I do think that word will spread I think there's going to be a long tail for Titanfall, partially because I think word will spread in the Call of Duty community. Oh, man, you got to check this out. This game's rad. But also, there's nothing coming out for a while on either console.
Yeah.
You know, you've got Infamous this month as the big PS4 release, and then it's kind of nothing on either platform.
Metal Gear demo.
A two-hour.
2 hours of Metal Gear.
40, 50 bucks, yeah, whatever it is. But I think by Titanfall 2, which Respawn has all but said, that's going to be on every console, and it should be at that point. Makes great sense for them and for gamers. I think Titanfall 2 has a pretty good chance to, if not maybe quite overtake Call of Duty, at least take like a huge, huge chunk of its market share.
My question for that, though, is how far out is that? Like, because it's one of those things, is this going to kill Call of Duty? No, because Call of Duty is going to be annual forever, right? Like, that's what the whole thing. There's always, every year, people are going to be super excited to play Call of Duty.
But are they, though? I mean, if it continues the way it's going, I mean, Sledgehammer has a big task on their hands this year with trying to reinvigorate. I mean, I finally jumped off the Call of Duty bandwagon two Call of Duties. I just, like, I can't. This is boring to me now. Like, it's all Call of Duty is to me is pull the left trigger to hone in on a guy, pull the trigger. It doesn't matter what gun you have. Literally doesn't matter. You could shoot anyone with any gun. Doesn't make a difference. And so I'm just, and the single player game is, the excuse for a campaign in Call of Duty is follow some AI guy, shoot a bunch of stuff, and then follow him to the next area.
They're just screaming at you. They're always mad at you no matter what you're doing.
So, Call of Duty needs, it's the curse of success, right? I mean, it's huge, and they can't change it too much, but man, they gotta change it.
I mean, I feel like we say this every year, and granted, again, we're on the outside, not being big FPS people, we, you know, aren't usually excited for Call of Duties, but every year they come out at their event, and they're like, here's what we're doing, this fish has texture, and there's a dog, and people are like, oh, I can't wait to try this, to play this.
And,
they get made fun of a lot, too.
Yeah,
I don't know, like, what the popular, I know Ghosts reviewed well, but I don't know, like, what the hardcore Call of Duty community thought of it, but like it did feel like, oh, you got this dog, but otherwise it's kind of the same as the other games. Like, they need to mix it up, and they will.
Agreed.
I think they know that. Like, you know, Sledgehammer and Activision, all these people are smart people, and I think that they're looking at Titanfall and understanding that Call of Duty needs to change, and I think it will.
Will there be mechs?
That's what I was gonna say. What are the chances? What are the chances they add mechs to Call of Duty?
I would bet the farm on it either this year or next.
Year.
But see, the thing is, you say that Call of Duty.
Not prepared for Mechfall.
The Call of Duty people are smart people. Well, the Respawn people are the original Call of Duty people.
Right?
They're really smart people.
I do. I 100% agree that Titanfall is going to take a big chunk of Call of Duty's business. You know, not necessarily overnight, but you know, we are going to see that as like in the chart of sales. I think we're going to see that as the turning point. But like I said, the counterpoint or what that hinges on is how much are they willing to take a risk on Call of Duty and how much will they innovate with it. They have to. I think they have to. It's got to look and feel. It's got to continue evolving with the times. You know, it's two generations, three generations old, this franchise is at this point.
Mm. You were talking about how for you, Titanfall felt a little too similar to Call of Duty, but maybe that similarity would, you know, be attractive to Call of Duty fans.
Could be, yeah. I mean, I think that's Totally intentional.
Maybe the Titanfall is just Call of Duty, but just different enough to feel.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think that's a coincidence. Yeah. I think that it's intentional that you can pick up, a Call of Duty fan can pick up Titanfall and understand immediately how to play.
Well, yeah, look, even the fonts are the same font, like the on-screen fonts are the same ones as in Call of Duty. That is not
none of that stuff's a coincidence, for sure.
Well,
Zampella.
We should be hearing more about this year's Call of Duty soon, so. We'll be watching that.
Yeah,
very
they usually
closely.
Reveal it around what, like NBA playoffs or something. They do a big commercial
it's before E3, right?
Yeah, isn't it pre E3? We usually go down and get an event
a little bit before E3. So we'll be watching carefully.
I wonder if like me saying Titanfall is like Call of Duty is like someone saying ping pong's like tennis. Well, you hit a ball with a paddle.
What's the difference?
But I mean, it's unfortunate. I'm at the point where you can't even. I won't even be excited when they announce Call of Duty. Like it's, they're gonna have to. They have to win me back at this point. Mm. And that's
you're gonna sit on your throne with your thumb like this, waiting.
Were you guys at the one where I think it was Black Ops or maybe Black Ops 2 where they announced it in this like stadium and then there was flames shooting off and Eminem came out and sang a song and then there was all this crazy stuff.
There was a
Every Call of Duty, isn't it?
There was that E3 party where they're like, remember where Tony Hawk was going to do skate tricks?
And yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, that was just an Activision party at E3.
Oh, but
then Tony Hawk's like, sorry, we can't use the ramp. We're like, oh, okay. Weird.
Anyway.
It was weird for Tony Hawk.
It was weird.